AI is conscious. AI is sentient. AI will replace programming. That's what everyone tells me is going to happen. But I think it won't be so easy. I'm Alex, and I'm a PhD student at MIT CCL working on integrating AI with programming. Today, I'll give you a glimpse of the challenges of this integration, as well as how it might play out moving forward. So let's begin with what's hard. Before we even talk about AI, let's begin by talking about human programming. Let's say I'm designing software for a restaurant management application. How would I do it? First, I'll do some high-level designing and writing of the code. We'll call that synthesis. Then, to make sure all the code is correct, I'll write some tests, verification. Finally, as every programmer knows, it's inevitable that I'll have bugs, so I'll have to go back and fix them again, repair. I'll iterate between synthesis, verification, and repair again and again until I end up with that perfect piece of software. These are core challenges of programming, whether human or automated. Now let's talk about AI. By show of hands, how many of you have heard of either GitHub Copilot or ChatGPT? A lot of you, almost everyone in the room. Awesome. And you're probably wondering, why don't we just get all of this cool technology to do everything for us? Well, let's think about what AI can do. Synthesis, supposedly, but verification and repair, not at all. On verification, somebody prompted Copilot to write a function that was supposed to validate JSON tokens. And guess what it said? Return true. It's always valid, all the time. That's exactly not what I mean when I say verification. Today's AI systems follow a paradigm that's closer to synthesis, synthesis, and more synthesis. Copilot generates code you don't like. What do? Delete it. Synthesize it again. But the synthesis itself isn't even good. Here's some evidence. A Harvard study showed that people failed to understand Copilot's generated code, leading to bugs that took a long time to uncover. And this one is outright scary. It terrifies me. Researchers at NYU showed that AI generates not just incorrect, but also vulnerable code that could cause security crises. So what's the takeaway here? We can't just have synthesis. We also need AI to do verification and repair to prevent all this scary stuff from happening. Next, let's move on to a fantastical world where AI has learned to do both verification and repair. Now, how can we design a system where we can smoothly integrate with to make programming easier? Let me show you one vision inspired by one of my personal projects. You'll see a common theme. While the AI does all the heavy lifting, the human ultimately still has control over what they do. So let's go back to the restaurant management application. I'll tell it that, and it'll synthesize some functionality that I might want my app to have. Since different restaurants have different needs, the system will ask me what I want instead of going autopilot all the way. This is human verification and repair. And once I tell it that, magic. The system will synthesize SQL queries describing precisely what I asked for. It can give me not only that, but also the entire database that supports the queries. And here's the key. By combining synthesis with verification, I can make sure that the query and schema are perfectly consistent with each other. But wait, this consistency check can make us go even further. Let's say I want to make some changes to the schema, for example, renaming price into cost. Now what? Amazing, the system can automatically figure out how to repair the queries, changing some of price into some of cost. But human or AI, nobody is perfect. So how do we find problems when they arise? The key lies in verification, of course. But it gets even better. We know the code is wrong, but how? Instead of relying solely on the user to fix the errors, the AI can also do automated repair, suggesting possible fixes, as you see here. The key is that through both verification and repair, I will be involved as much as the system does. I'll look at the validity of the test cases. I'll add my own to suit my needs. I'll look at the code that it's generated, tell it what to fix. I can collaborate on the system and iterate on all dimensions, correctness, readability, and even performance. Together, we can get the perfect implementation of our restaurant management app. As you saw, the key to this collaboration is to have both humans and AI totally involved in all three stages. But right now, AI is focused on synthesis. We're not there yet. It leaves the tedious tasks of verification to repair and to you and me. And that's why it produces so much wrong code. As we scale to much larger software systems, like the ones powering the largest companies in the world, the situation worsens. AI is not going to be able to reason about code bases that are millions of lines long, and it is not going to get it right the first time. So unless we want our AI to infiltrate our code bases with wrong and scrutable and insecure code, we need a future of AI-assisted software engineering where both the AI and the human are involved in all three components, synthesis, verification, and repair. But above all, we need to have humans like you and me in the loop to make sure the code that we get is the code that we want. Thank you.